How to perform rescue breathing during an overdose using a bag valve mask. Bag valve mask ventilation can be done with one person or two, but two-person bag valve mask ventilation is easier and more effective because it helps to have two hands on the mask so you can keep a tight seal. Check out the video in this series, Two-Person Bag Valve Mask Ventilation, for tips if you do have a second responder. This video covers what to do if you are responding to an overdose alone, and you should watch it for the full process even if you have a second responder. In this video, you will learn about what to do first, getting a proper seal, 6 seconds saves lives, what to look out for, and when to stop. Ensure you are wearing an N95 mask if possible. First, give one dose of Narcan and call 911. Then begin rescue breathing. Put the person in the recovery position if they start breathing at a normal rate or if you need to leave the room to get a phone. Getting a proper seal is an important part of bag valve mask ventilation to ensure that no air is escaping through the sides of the mask and to ensure that oxygen is going into the lungs and not the stomach. It's best for you to position yourself behind the person's head when you are responding. We want to use the CE grip. It's called CE grip because your thumb and index finger make the shape of a C, and the other three make the shape of an E. You place the E fingers under the mandible, or chin, and pull the mandible upward, while the thumb and index fingers create a C around the mask, and then press down against the mask. Hold the mask between your thumb and index finger around the stem. Place the nasal portion of the mask over the nose high enough to cover the bridge without air leaks. Make sure the mask isn't touching the person's eyes. Next, cover the bridge of the nose and the person's lower lip with the mask to achieve a proper seal. Grip the mandible with the three fingers of the E grip and pull the chin into the mask, creating a seal and opening the airway. You're going to lift the chin with your E fingers to make sure the airway is open. Be sure to pull up only the bony parts of the jaw because pressure to the soft tissues of the neck or under the chin may obstruct the airway. Make sure you keep a tight seal around the person's nose and mouth with one hand and squeeze the bag with the other hand. You want to squeeze the bag once every 6 seconds, and each squeeze should last about 1 second, providing just enough air to see the chest rise. Give 10 to 12 breaths per minute. Count out loud to keep track. Make sure you wait the full 6 seconds. You don't want to overventilate because it can cause a greater chance that the air will get into the stomach. Look for proper chest rise during ventilations. If you don't see the chest rise, reposition the chin. Make sure that you are squeezing the bag with enough force to make the lungs rise and fall. Be sure to look out for gurgling noises or other signs that the person may vomit. Sometimes this happens once the Narcan is starting to take effect, but before the person is conscious or breathing on their own. If a person is making gurgling noises, flip them on the side in the recovery position until they have vomited or until the sounds have stopped. Then, put them back onto their back and continue rescue breathing if they're still not breathing on their own. Look for signs of breathing between bag squeezes. You will be able to see the exhalation as condensation and hear it flowing through the mask valves. Continue operating the bag valve mask until the person starts breathing again on their own or until first responders arrive. It's important to practice using a bag valve mask before using it while responding to an actual overdose. Practice with another person or use a dummy if you have one. That's how to perform rescue breathing during an overdose using a bag valve mask. To reduce the risk of COVID transmission, be sure to watch the video PPE Needed to Perform Assisted Breathing Using a Bag Valve Mask During COVID-19.